Zo, oké. Dat is voor jou. Dit is voor. Oh, oh. This is.
Difficult!
My dear, what are you gonna do now?
Ik wil deze weg hebben.
Emergency, what is it?
Life raft.
The life raft.
En gaat die bij jou lekker?
Ja, maar hier ligt de scheidslijn.
Hier precies.
Ja,
zo. We zijn hier even een dingetje voor. Zo. Zo, zo, oké. Okay. Zo. 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 Oké. Okay. Dat is voor jou. Dit is voor. Oh, oh. Zo.
We hebben het wel goed geregeld zo. Dan krijgen we geen ruzie.
Nee, dat is waar.
The wood that I have to put against the ceiling is a little tricky because it's not straight corners like a lot of things, and I really need to measure twice or three times to be really sure to do it right the first time.
This is
difficult!
And I'm gonna show you why. It's all angles and curves and curves on curves and curves on angles and whatever. I'm gonna show you on the other side. Wait a minute.
So look, this is a curve. Then that is a curve. It's like this, but also like this.
So now I have to make something that fits underneath, but it needs to fit precisely with this curve, which is a double curve. But when it's ready, it's gonna look good.
Ik heb de plaat ondertussen op maat gemaakt en met een paar schroeven vastgezet, zodat ik hem hier kan aftekenen.
To sort the hole for the hedge, which is not possible from the inside, because you can't see the hedge from the inside.
Because there's so many different strange angles, I needed something like this. Couldn't find it in a shop somewhere, so I made it myself.
I hope it works.
Things go well till now. Love to do it. Not a carpenter, never been, but I think I'm doing a pretty decent job. Oh yes.
This is it for now. Next time, I hope to do the rest.
Gaat goed naar beneden.
Nou, het is een beetje behelpen.
And here we go again. My dear, what are you gonna do now?
Ik wil deze weg hebben.
You're just gonna remove that.
Kan dat met dit?
Yeah, you can.
En hoe moet ik dat doen? Zo of zo?
Just, you're good at demolishing. So whatever you do, you're gonna break it down anyway.
So here we go again.
It's a talent, dear. It's a gift.
Kijk.
Oh man.
Dit zit allemaal vast nu. Dus als ik die hoekjes daar weghaal, mm-hmm, dan kan ik alles weghalen.
That's Dutch for remove everything.
Kijk. Mm-hmm. Kijk, 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 kijk.
Watch your face, watch your face. She looks too happy.
Yes.
Oh, come on.
Saturday, time to do something else then. Working on the boat or doing our kind of daily jobs or video editing. So we're going to take a look in the village.
looking for a nice coffee shop, enjoying the weather. It's already spring over here, and the water's calm, smooth. We love it here. Don't know if you can see it, big fishy. We were told that in the summertime, late spring, summertime, barracudas are coming into the marina. Already hear the summer noises starting, loud music, but maybe there's something to do in the village. Over there is the boat stuff shop, and there's a lot of little restaurants all over the place. Good coffee, good sandwich, good meal. That's a butcher.
Like I said earlier, sometimes when you start working on something, you meet all kind of new things. You gotta change or renew, and this is one of them. We're gonna do veneer on here, like there and over there, but we had to renew these edges. You need to be very precise, because all those edges, this is 22.5 degrees, and all those edges need to fit. So this was a little too scary to film, so I didn't film it. This is what we're busy with. This is the Indian apple veneer that we are putting on all those surfaces. But it's very scary because it is very thin, very fragile, and needs to be precise, because you can't do it again. We don't have enough to do this again.
So we take the risk.
We take the risk. We are so risky. We do a little overlap over here because we're going to do a layer of epoxy with polyurethane varnish on top of it, two layers. It's going to be quite a thick layer of epoxy, so this edge is not a problem. Now you feel it and you don't even really see it. But when the epoxy's on it, it must be okay.
We are so excited about this stuff.
Are we excited? Yes, we are excited. It's
scared.
It's scary. We're scared. We're scared to death, actually. But it's exciting. It's going to be so beautiful. If we don't ruin it. If we don't ruin it. I don't think you could see this when the camera was up there, but we made a little mistake, and that was we used too little of those wood strips underneath the veneer. So it was a little wobbly over here and it got stuck over here, so we got a bubble over here. We made a cut a little bit out of it, tried to mask the damage. So there's a little damage, it's not really obvious. We can only hope that when we put the epoxy on it, you won't see it anymore. Another scary thing. Gluing the whole thing together. Somewhere here should be that hatch. No, somewhere here is that hatch. And I need to cut it out, but I need to cut it out nicely. So that's a very, very scary business. Thank you.
So this is absolutely annoying. I did my first layer of epoxy, a thin layer, to close off all the gaps and the whatevers, and just didn't work out nicely. There's bubbles everywhere. And I tried all the methods that I saw on YouTube, also from professionals, with a hair dryer, with a blowtorch, and it just doesn't work. Maybe the layer is too thin, maybe it's just bad quality. I don't know. It looks great though, the color itself, but with light in it, it's horrible. So maybe I need to let it harden out, then sand it again. I don't know. Not happy, not happy, not happy. But the color is gorgeous. While my dear wife over there is making lots of noise, I'm trying to redo the epoxy for the counters. As far as we know now, it was just too cold for the epoxy. So we gotta sand away the micro bubbles and then epoxy again with warm weather, higher temperatures, and then a thicker layer. Wat zien wij hier? Wat doe je hier? Wat doe je hier?
Okay. Dat is een things to do lijstje. Die alleen ik kan lezen.
Een things to do?
Die.
It's a lot of things to
die.
Do.
Die. En die.
That's all.
Ja.
Yeah. Our things to do list. So we're busy.
Look at this. Isn't this a little bit too much? All those anchors. I got 6 anchors here. Okay, the little one, I get that. That's for the dinghy. And that's the main anchor. But the Virus aluminum anchor. This strange thing. With whatever that is. And then this one. And that one. Weird.
So, those are noticed.
It's a mess. One of the chores when you're refitting your boat. Fine dust, not good for your vacuum cleaner. So it was full of it was really full of
dust.
Dust, yeah. Sanding dust. It was making a lot of noise because there were parts of veneer in it, old veneer and other kind of stuff. It was as annoying as a
Hoi.
Wat ben je aan het doen?
I'm removing as much stainless steel as possible. This boat is way too heavy in the back. So I removed already this railing, which makes no sense at all. I'm gonna remove these tensions because we don't have little children anymore. And we need to make something else for this. It's way too heavy. And I want the boat, the emergency, what is it?
Life raft.
The life raft. I want to put the life raft somewhere else so we have more space here. It's too heavy. Too much. And it's nice weather, so. I have to remove the underside of this one, this thing, to get to these nuts. But it's about 50 screws, I guess. Man. Who cares?
Geen klusje voor nu, wat je even doet.
Nah, it's not a job for now because I think I need a dinghy for that. Or we need to put the boat on the shore. Or just leave it. Tada! Ze zijn zwaar, man.
Ja.
Ik denk ze zo 5 kilo per stuk wegen en ze zijn er hier al 6.
Ja.
Gewoon een massief roest van staal. Leuk! Volgende.
Ja, maar waarom moet dat per se gelijk nu? Ja, maar we hebben de slaapkamer nog geen eens af. Ja, maar dan kan je toch ook zinniger besteden? Ja, maar nu is het overal een zooi.
Luister nou eens even, er verandert niks. Het ding zit op 4. Luister nou eens even. Er verandert helemaal niks. Dat ding zit op 4 van die schuifpunten zit dat vast. En als je die losdraait, dan kun je zo de hele boel naar achteren schuiven. Dus dat, ik heb alleen maar een schroefdraadje nodig. Komt goed, komt allemaal goed.
Ja, maar je bent soms wat impulsief.
Ik?
Ja.
Impulsief?
Ja.
Nee, ik weet niet eens hoe het woord spelt.
Maar moet je niet eerst een touw...
Wat zit je weer te dobbelen, Bim?
Moet je niet eerst een touw vastmaken voordat je de zijkant eraf haalt?
Ja, nee, dat natuurlijk wel. Dat wel. Maar het is maar even idee. En dan kan deze ook een stuk hoger nog.
Ja, maar dat hoeft niet.
Maar dan zijn we dit wel kwijt hier.
Ja, dat zou wel lekker zijn. Ziet er wel een stuk beter uit, denk ik.
Ja, je kijkt er toch even gewoon op hier. Ik haal dit schroefje los en het hele ding komt naar beneden. alles zit gewoon zo... Hier, dit zit niet eens vast.
Oh.
Boom!
Ben je klaar?
Ja, nou klaar. Ik heb het een ander weggehaald. Ja,
oh, dat scheelt een stuk.
Ja, hè?
Ja, dat is een stuk.
Ja, niet alles. Die staanders daar, die moeten er nog af.
Ja.
En die paal daar moet nog weg. Die is van de oude windmolen.
Nee, maar dit is wel prettig.
Ja, hè? En als we die daar nog vast kunnen maken. Als we dat rekwerk. Als we dat aan de Davids vast kunnen maken.
Ja.
Dan hebben die staanders helemaal niet meer nodig. Nee. Het is alleen zo, dan kan de Griek niet ver genoeg heen en weer. Dus het is.
Tijdelijke oplossing.
Het is een tijdelijke oplossing. Ja.
Maar het scheelt wel weer een hoop troep.
Ja, toch?
Ja.
Leuk.